All right, shalom, 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 yom tov, barakatah, barakat, baraka, tami, tamidas, tamidims. All praises to Yahuwah Bashem, Yahusha HaMashiach, the Malak. All right. Now, many Hebrews make their boast in Torah and say that they are Hebrews and make their boast of Torah. But a lot of them also deny the New Covenant or the Brit Hadashah, the New Testament, and deny the Messiah, but make their boast in Torah, okay? But also say they're Hebrews. So let's look at the word Torah in Hebrew and also look at the word Torah as a picture and what's the message that is being shown in the word Torah. Because I have Hebrews that make their boast in Torah, but deny the Messiah. So with this being said, this right here, Hebrew reads from right to left, first of all. So for those who don't know, this is the first letter. You don't start reading it from right here. You actually start reading it from right here. So this is a Tav, which is the letter T. Okay. Then this is a Vav. Some people actually say Y, which is two V's to make the W, or some people say Ua, which is a U, which is the W is double U as it says. So you got a Tav, then you got the Vav, and in modern Hebrew, you got a Vav by itself is a V, a Vav with a dot above it, kind of like, oh, in the sky, you see a bird or something. Oh, look at that bird, all right? Then you got a vibe with a dot on the side, kind of like a woman holding a purse, like, ooh, you know, that's a nice purse on this on her side. So dot above is an O, dot on the side is a U, and a vibe by itself is a V. Then the vibe itself represents a peg or a nail. Then you have the resh, which is the letter R in English. All right. Pictorially, it shows a head of a man. Think of a child when they draw a head of a person. That's the head. That's the hair. You see it? All right. So pictograph Hebrew shows that the resh is a head of man. And we know who the head of man is if you read 1 Corinthians chapter 11 starting around verse 2. All right. And then the hey, which is the letter H in English, but in Hebrew it's the letter hey. Pictographically, it shows a man. Alright? So, past Torah just being five books of Moses, past all of that. If we read the word Torah as a picture, it shows on cross, because remember this is cross sticks, so on cross, now we have a peg, so on cross, nailed, the head of man, a man. So that is the real message and the true Torah if you read it as a picture. It shows that the Messiah would die for your sins. And you can't denounce this if you're a Hebrew because I'm actually showing it to you in ancient Hebrew, which a lot of Hebrews make their boast in. So, once again, look closely at this. Torah. For any Hebrew that makes their boast in Torah, and any Hebrew that, oh, you know, the modern Hebrew is Yiddish, and it ain't real Hebrew. So let's look at what you call real Hebrew. That's what you call real Hebrew. And that is the word Torah. And it shows you that on the cross, because these is cross sticks, you see it? Bam. Cross sticks, peg, head of man, man. And that shows you who died for your sins. It was already written before it even happened. So the reality is, if someone feels like, okay, they follow Torah and they only follow the Old Testament, but they say they are Hebrew, and they see this and denounce this, remember, all Israel ain't Israel. And just because someone wears garments, just because someone wears tzitzits or a mitre and all that stuff, turban or whatever they want to put on their head, you know, tunics and, you know, they say shalom, ak, or shalom, whatever. At the end of the day, if you follow the true Torah, then you know that he died for your sins. Because pictograph Hebrew shows you that. Once again, this is the Tav, the last letter in Hebrew. Okay, you got Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, He. I'm going to stop right there because I done said five words and some people might not know what I said. So Aleph, Bet. That's how you get alphabet. The Greeks copied the Hebrew. So Aleph, they wrote Alpha. In Hebrew, Bet, the Greeks wrote Beta. Gimel, the Greeks put Gamma. Dalet, the Greeks put Delta. Okay? So, if you go to Psalms 119, you'll see the whole Hebrew alphabet right there in your King James Bible. Okay? So, let's not make a separation. But in the King James version of the Bible, you can go to Psalms 119 and see the Aleph Bet. And then you're going to see Aleph Bet, Gimel, Dalet, He, Vav, Zan, Chet, Tet, Yud, Kaf, Lamet, Mem, Nun, Samek, Ayin, Pei, Sadi, Kuf, Resh, Shin, Tav. So all 22 letters of the Hebrew alphabet is right there. But once again, for those Hebrews that are making their boast in Torah, preaching and teaching that Christ didn't die for our sins, it's a lie. Because the very thing that you're making your boast in, Torah, tells you the same exact thing. That on the cross, nailed the head of man, amen. So that's the real revelation and the truth about Torah for anybody that follows Torah. Christ died for our sins, and that's what Torah points to. Remember, the Torah is a shadow. So being under the law is like living in the shadow. Okay? Imagine living in the shadow of yourself but not being you. Okay? So the Torah is just the shadow of Christ. It points to Christ. All right? So, once again, like I said, the word Torah points to him dying for our sins, all right? And with that being said, just wanted to make a quick video showing y'all what the Torah is really about, okay? It's more than just five books of Moses. The Torah pictorially shows that Christ died for our sins. And with that said, salute, and keep following Torah, the real Torah, Jesus Christ.